above, this hadith is in Bukhari, about three men. One of them had beautiful hair, the other man had beautiful skin, and the third person had beautiful eyes. What happened was, they had a lot of wealth, and they had beautiful skin, beautiful hair, beautiful eyes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given them this ni'mah. Allah wanted to test them one day. And you know what a test is? It's not so that Allah can know. Allah knows everything, past, present, and future. However, when Allah puts us through a test, the test is for us. For you, I mean, test is not to see an outcome necessarily, but rather for you to recognize things in yourself and work on yourself. So these three men, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away the blessings from each one of them. The skin, the person with the good skin, he became a leper. The person who had beautiful hair, he became bald. And the person with beautiful eyes, Allah made him blind. And he took away their wealth until people start to say, "Ooh, these people, they must be very bad for God, for Allah to take away what they have." Similarly, what they did to Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam, they kept saying, "This man must be a bad person for God to take away his health, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take his health and his children and his wealth." But he was a messenger and prophet of Allah, little did they know. So then an angel came to the first man, the leper. He says, "If Allah gives you back your skin and your wealth, you won't forget Allah? And would you give to those who ask, the poor and the needy, from your wealth?" He said, "Yes, yes, yes." So the angel said, "Oh Allah, give him back his skin." And he asked to raise sheep, to have sheep as his business. Then he went to the bald person. Same thing. "Would you like Allah to give you back your hair and your wealth, and you will donate and give to those who have the right, and you won't forget Allah?" He said, "Yes, yes, yes." So he gave him back his hair, and he said, "I like goats." So Allah gave him goats as a business. The third person, the blind, said, "If Allah gave you back your sight, will you thank Allah and will you remember the rights of those who are deprived?" He said, "Yes, yes." He said, "What do you like of wealth?" He said, "I like camels." Allah gave him the business of camel. He had one camel, then the second, then the third, and his business grew, and Allah gave him his sight back. After years and years, the angel came back in the form of a poor man. He came up to the leper, who had his skin beautiful. He said, "Please, my family is poor. Allah has given you as I see. Donate something of it. I can see that nothing will be depleted from your wealth." The man looked at him and said, "Go away, I have no time for you. My business, my distractions." He said, "But wasn't there ever a day in your life that you suffered at least one day of what I'm suffering? Is it possible?" The leper said to him, "Never. I do not recall. Maybe a few days I went through some sickness, but everybody goes through sickness." He said, "Wasn't there a day you were poor?" He says, "Poor? This wealth I inherited from my parents and my family and from my knowledge." He forgot that it is Allah who blessed him. He thought, "I made it grow." So the angel said, "Oh Allah, return him back to the way he was." Now it's a punishment. Before, it was a test. Now it's a punishment. The second person, same thing, with the hair. "Wasn't there one day that you were poor? Wasn't there one day that you suffered like me?" He said, "Never. My parents, my knowledge, my intellect, my strength, this is how I made it." He said, "Oh Allah, return him back to the way he was." Then he came to the blind man, but this time the blind man, who had his sight, he said to him, "Yes, take whatever you wish. Take all of it, or a little bit of it, or half of it, or don't take it all. It's your choice. For not a single bit of it came from myself. Everything I have is from Allah." The angel then revealed himself and said to him, "I am the angel that came to you before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your wealth and bless your health and keep you with what you have." Now he has this reward of the dunya and the akhirah.